What's up, guys? This is a review of the Canon PowerShot SX60HS digital camera for macro photography. So this is not an SLR camera. This is a point and shoot, but it is a high class point and shoot camera. And I use a Raynox macro clip-on lens. This is the DCR 150 and it clips onto the inside of the Canon lens just like that, and you have a nice 60 fps 1080p macro video and photography camera. And I love this setup. I've been using it for probably around 2 to 3 years. I got this brand new refurbished from Canon. The camera I'm recording with is the SX60HS, the older model of this. There's also a 50HS, and I skipped that one. I didn't buy the one in between. So this one is probably around 400 brand new. You could probably find it for 300 something. I bought it for 300 something refurbished from Canon, but you can get it used on eBay for much cheaper. So you can get a $300 budget macro setup compared to SLR cameras with this lens, which is around $75, also on eBay or Amazon or elsewhere. And this is a lens made in Japan, and there are two versions of it, the M150 model and the DCR 250 model. So 150 and 250, I have them both, and right now I'm using the 150. I'm not sure where my 250 is, but I like that one better, so I would recommend the 250. That's the one I bought first, and I used that for a long time. But they both work great and do a similar thing, which is get super close-up macro shots. So all you got to do with your camera is power it on. I go into AV mode, aperture priority, and you can also use manual focus. Now, one of the things I don't like about this camera that I like better about the SX30HS is that to focus, you push down, like a down arrow and an up arrow. So when you're trying to focus on something very specific, what you do is you don't let go in time. So it's like that game at an arcade where the light spins around and you got to get it on the jackpot circle. It's hard to get it exact. So to sort of alleviate that, what you can do is move the camera back and forth physically until you're close and focused where you need to be, which is about 6 inches away from your target. So the great thing about this camera is that you have an amazing zoom, 65 times, which means you can get way close. You can zoom in on the moon. You can zoom in, you know, far, far away. But I use it to zoom in close on insects and bugs. And you get about 6 inches away and you get your focus and you can get some amazing photos using this lens and the camera setup. So the PowerShot isn't the only camera that's compatible with this. So long as the camera has ridges on the inside, it should be good to go. What I would recommend, and this will, you know, help a lot, is buy the lens first. You know, spend the $80 and get this lens, and then go to a electronics store and just clip on the front just to see if it'll fit. So this is a very tight fit with the 60HS, but I make it work. And I actually one time I pulled this off and the inside of the lens came out, so I lost that along with the other macro lens. But once I find it, it clips right back in. Nothing's broken, but I don't really need it. I don't care about looks. So this just clips on the front and you got your super macro close-up setup, and you can get amazing quality photographs and videos. So most SLR cameras can't get you the high quality videos. They can get you a nice photos, but you'll spend up to $1,000 just to get a nice SLR macro setup with a big macro lens.